in your phone, let me take you home. I wanna take you home. It's so rare that I'm here, don't plan on staying too long. So you should come here, sit your ass on this throne. It's a special affair, better act like you know who I am. Who I am. I bet this Patron make you feel nice and comfortable. Trying to act nice, girl, your cover's long. But you already knew that.
Y'all ain't never been to a party before?
Even if you don't wanna stay. You can't get in shape because you don't have an hour to go do cardio every day. Well, nobody has time for that.
Saw that thing so beautiful. Da-da. She just hit my heart, oh. Da-da. Full force and she got me like. Da-da. I be like,
da-da.
Baby,
da-da.
Why you so fine?
But something about this place feels off. I can feel it in my plums. I'll meet you and Overlord Amers at the rendezvous point.
It's Big Daddy Zack.
Your Overlord is here.
Girth Burns.
The Girth Burns returns. Girth Burns returns. Da, 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 da. Can't bet on games anymore. What do you mean? take yourself out of that. Dude, I put $50 on, and that's all I'm putting on. Until, like, next season. $50 a season. But I think I can get through next season. I turned that 50 into 150 at one point. Then fucked around some of it away. But I'm back at, like, 125. So, still above where I started. That's what, you know, that's what it's all about. Can't get too crazy with it, you know? Just bet parlays with, like, $1 and $2. And work your way from there. That's all I'm saying. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? That's a GG. So the give. What up, y'all? Guys, here we go. Girth burns. My girth doesn't burn. That's just the name of the man, the myth, the legend. The new addition to the Girth family. Crap, come on, come on, come on. Don't change screens. Don't change screens. Don't change screens. Turn on, turn on, turn on. If this doesn't turn on time, sometimes it flips everything on the small screen over to there, and then I have to move everything back over. I think we're good. Anyway, we got Andrew, we got Nian, we got Heartpiece. We got Juliana and myself here. Thank you guys. Thank you guys for being here, man. So freaking pumped. The first night of Girth Burns. Girth Burns is Asian. What's up, Laura? How you doing tonight? Oh, shit. Everything's dying. Phone's dying. Controller's dying. But wait. I forgot this one didn't work very well. I'm gonna put on the silver one. First night, though, I don't know if I like this Girth. I might need to recreate him, but we're gonna give him a shot. Give me a second. He's a point guard, and he's also Asian. So we got our first Asian Girth. I felt like it was important. It was just like the default that I looked the most Girth out of all of them. So I went with him, and I was like, you know, we might just stick with this base format and then change the hair. Hair is very important to the Girths. The Girth family. As you guys know, I mean, here in the guild, we take our girth very, very seriously. We need to make sure everything is up to standard. Everything has to be adequate. It has to work. We're gonna get there right now. Let's do it. We're gonna need to go somewhere else. Let's see without that. Lucky.
Hey. Hey.
Is going to be in the way and it might fall us.
When I come through Beamer, ain't no X. When I come through Porsche, ain't no box. If I come through range, ain't no sport.
Alright.
Nah, my Xbox was a sport. On and off court, I put numbers on the board. I financed it all, but who keep a score? We talking fair pay. I know. All things ain't equal, so
and you can hear
not pay it for it. The irony of growing up poor is you gotta pay for it. Why you think they
green screen and we would just hold it on that?
Why you think we got about for it? Why you think my got me box for it?
Whatever, fuck it.
For it. I had to fight for it. Some of my cousins for it. A lot of.
We're in high school, mid-range slasher. We're in high school. Girth is in high school.
Hey,
green screen's giving us a striptease.
We rise. When I come through Beamer, ain't no X.
Hey,
you are now a knight.
Thank you for fucking.
Perfect.
I appreciate that, dude, big time. There we go. Now we got 100,000 in the account. It didn't have that in there the other day. All right, so we need our quickness up. Why you think my got me box for lateral quickness? All right, we're gonna spend a good amount here. Let's free the guys for my king, still a million dollar mission. Layup up. All my going for it, yelling same team. How you mean? Thought you knew about the team. All my going for it, yelling same team. How you mean? Thought you knew about the team. All my going for it, yelling same team. How you mean? Thought you knew about the team. I was wanting to do like 50, but we might go above that. Put our 3 at 65, our mid-range at 70. Definitely want my free throw up at 70. We're already where I was wanting. Rappers repeat last line that they said on the low like ground ball, hustle like loose ball. Skinny bank bro, bigger 50. Than all y'all. Skinny had to flex up on all y'all. I was a team sport, now it's ISO ball. Went solo on that, but it's still the same. No, I never chase fame, it's a 2-for-1 thing. Everybody think they know me, don't know my middle name. Everybody yelling. Don't worry about rebounds right now. Anything I bring to the game, don't show on stat sheets. With me, my visits be tax free. International road, it ain't duty free.
Let's do it.
I'm like,
pay me 30,000. Like let's do it. Let's do it. Girth became a baller right now before your eyes. He's 80 overall now. Going for it, yeah, the same team. How you mean? Thought you knew about the team. All my going for it, yeah, the same team. How you mean? Thought you knew about the team. All my going for it, yeah, the same team. How you mean? What you know about the team? When I come through Beamer, ain't no X. When I come through Porsche, ain't no box. If I come through Range, ain't no Spark. Kids yelling key like no steals from the porch.
Definitely have a favorite team. Kidding me. Alright.
Tell me what you know about a player. I can't game up.
Let's do it. Girth has become a baller before your eyes. Oh, Andrew gifted the sub to Ian. You kidding me? And that's a total of 29 subs gifted, Andrew. I got that. Did not have to do that. But my internet provider can get fucked. I am so tired of capping my internet. They're doing it everywhere as of late. Thank they're not. And it's getting fucked. Here we go. Hold on.
Hello and welcome to another presentation of Garden State IAA Hoops. I'm Joe Lamy, joined by Drake Hugo and Danny Hogger. Tonight, the Newark East Eagles are up against the North High Dragons. Danny, your thoughts on this one?
Well, the big story tonight, Junior is not in the lineup. We don't know what his status is for the entire game,
Junior.
But he was spotted in street clothes. Overall, a huge blow to the Eagles.
Serious, we gotta watch this shit.
There's the coming off the floor for your and the Eagles look to make something happen, and that pass is airmailed and thrown out of bounds.
Oh, that can't feel good. The Eagles look really sloppy here early. This could be a long night for them.
And he controls it up top. Come on. Backdoor cut, easy look, and he missed it. How'd that not go in?
Devastating miss right there. The Eagles can't get anything going.
And the ball's knocked loose. Here the Dragons go the other way. A 2-on-1, and they'll finish with an easy bucket.
Newark just looks lost, Joe, without Junior in the lineup.
And that does it for the first half of play. The Dragons up on top, up by 10.
Anything.
Don't move a muscle. We'll be back right after this.
The annual choir concert.
Yeah, fellas, here's the deal. We're getting blown out.
Oh, Knights of the Guild. We got 33. That's Larry Bird.
All right. Second half. I don't care what happens. watching us play hard every possession.
Shit's about to go down.
Ball, rebound, play D every possession. Get some stops.
Why is he talking so quiet?
Now we can work ourselves back into this. Yeah, you play at a time, all right?
Sounds good.
Girth. That's the new Girth. That's the fresh face of Girth, guys.
I was hard to watch up there.
I'm about to enter the game, guys. What do you think? Enter?
I said I'm going in.
Hey, y'all, huddle up. Y'all playing. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. This ain't over yet. This ain't over yet. This ain't over yet. This ain't over yet.
Settle down. Settle down.
We talked about this. You need to keep that knee in check.
Nah, I'm good to go, coach. It's my choice.
My choice.
Okay.
We got to play hurt, man. We got to play hurt. Let's do it.
Win on three. Bring it in. One, two, three. Win. Let's go, fellas. Let's go.
Let's go. I can't move it.
I don't have any speeches for you. Just possessions. One at a time. Let's turn this thing around right now. Go time on three. One, two, three. Go time.
Hobbling onto the floor. Let's go.
And so it's North High with the ball. 10-point lead. This is their biggest lead of the game.
And Junior playing on a weakened knee. You just wonder how long he's going to be able to last out there. Surely they'll want to take precaution with him.
Here's Stopper. Takes a three. Sinks the tray.
Oh, talk about falling asleep on defense. What were they thinking leaving him open for that three?
And with the injury Junior is trying to play through, I believe he picked it up at the end of last game.
Yeah, it seems like an innocuous play where he felt a strange sensation in his knee. Unfortunately, it just hasn't gone away and nagged him since.
Let's go. Come back down.
And here's Coral. 9 points in this one. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
Jump ball, boys. Jump
Very
balls.
Very quick hands on that steal. Great D.
Junior outside. Charles Williams with the block. And they'll keep possession. Carceda, that's good.
Not much resistance inside.
They're getting outworked and overpowered in there.
Outside, it's Williams. Pass to Powell. Off target from outside. The Eagles trailing.
And for North High, what a start to the game. Every play executed to perfection, and that made the game look easy. Great job from them all around.
On the wing, Christian Sheffield, defended by Stauffer. Jonathan Lack on the wing. Back to Marceda, and here's Sheffield. Junior up top, high post shot. And a misfire there from Junior. Wonder if that leg is still bothering him. To the inside. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw. And the stats in the first half, as favorable as they are, they don't even tell the whole story, guys.
It's true. The Dragons looked like they were playing against pylons in that first half.
NBA hang time, too, on SNES.
I know New York East has more heart than what they showed. Hopefully Junior's return can remind them how to compete.
And Junior can't connect there. The knee could still be an issue. Outside Jones. The kick out to Williams. North High, no good that time. Here's Junior, and he banks in the layup.
I like the urgency of Junior's drive. Plenty of raw potential there. He could develop into an unstoppable move.
Pass to Hopkins. Nice D from Dave Zadierko. Well, throughout this season, Junior has been playing in the shadow of his dad. Duke was just a huge figure in the basketball community of this area.
And that's been an added layer to his success, following his father's footsteps after his passing.
Junior's story is one that you could see in a documentary one day.
And here's Lack for three. Connects it from downtown. Fantastic read by Junior. You see him picking up the game more and more out there.
Now here's Williams. Covered by Junior.
Down seven, let's
go. Timeout called by the Dragons.
Quinn Mason. Doug Evans. KJ Dane.
Outside Gibson.
Take he had to play
Williams.
Her.
Outside Jones. Outside it's Williams. Swings it to Gibson. Shoots over Day. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Eagles.
I get a bucket here.
And here are the Eagles now. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Shots good by Mason.
Let's go.
You wonder, guys, are they extending their defense too much right now? Giving up way too many points inside.
Yeah, it's really becoming noticeable during this last stretch. Williams with the bucket. And with the way that Junior has burst onto the scene, there's some talk going around that he's going to get offers to play at the next level.
And he's got such raw talent. There's no doubt about that. But every college can see the ceiling Junior has and wants to get him into their program. He'll have a lot of options to choose from by the time he ends high school.
Both shots are good from the stripe.
This is cool. I love that they added this again. Playing
North High in the lead. Outside, Gibson.
I think he even played Pass to college, Sousa. It seems like. Yeah, they're talking.
The kick out to Williams. And a miss there on the triple.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Yeah, Drake, they have battled to a standstill on the boards. But the game's not over yet. We'll see who keeps up this energy.
We've got a 9 second difference between the shot clock and game clock here. Hawkins with it. Now Evans defending. Back to Gibson. And the layup is good.
Blocked it.
Strong take to the rim, unafraid of the bigger defender.
Well, you have to be aggressive when you're on the wrong side of a size mismatch.
And here are the Eagles now. A 7 point differential. Pass to Mason. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
I need to start going up.
Yeah, Mason has quickly risen to the challenge of the power forward position.
Dominating.
Goes inside looking to create.
First trip to the line for him here.
At the line for
and he makes both free throws.
Cut the lead in half.
Some great free throw shooting so far in the second half.
They've been perfect from the line so far. They should keep trying to initiate contact to get back there.
Outside Jones. Swings it to Gibson. Just three on the clock.
I swat that. Yeah, I swatted the shit out of
so far in this
Let's
one.
Go, dude.
Dragons are out in front, up by five. And we'll be back right after this to
bring... This is thieving. No homo.
Well, as the fourth quarter gets going, you look at this game. Since Junior... So teams deciding to change it up.
We need to, man. Me and Fox need to play NBA.
The Eagles with the ball. They trail by one. And you look at Powell, just a tremendous athlete. Who does he remind you of, guys?
Well, the first guy you have to think of is Aaron Gordon. He has that blend of athleticism and speed and power, too. I mean, that has scouts just drooling all over this guy. He plays like a walking highlight reel.
Again with the miss there. Junior really struggling to play to his normal standards. Pass
I remember
to Coral.
Playing the other night. It was frustrating me. This QK is a little.
They've played just over 3.5 minutes now into this fourth quarter.
I love when Marcedo leverages his reach and height on D, able to cleanly deny the shot attempt.
Junior just can't seem to get anything going right now, and you can just tell that he isn't close to 100% right now. Jones, no good. Drive now by Junior.
Thank you.
The Eagles needed that one. And of course, Junior's the guy they look to get it for them.
Now a timeout called by North High.
Let's go, dude. 48-48. 1 minute left. We got this.
Here's Coral. James Marcedo with the block.
And what a morale boost it must be to have Junior back on the floor. He might not be at 100%, but just having him as a threat out there as a scorer and defender makes everyone feel and play better.
And it's the Dragons missing again.
And now they decide to intentionally foul. And the Eagles will call time here.
This is a huge possession.
Good teams have to execute under pressure.
And the foul is called. He grabbed him intentionally there for some reason.
Maybe he's just trying to slow the pace down. I don't really know. Strange move one way or the other.
And now we've got an intentional foul. He drops the first one, and that'll put him up by two.
Growing up in Newark has its perks. Junior got to hone his skills on the hard courts, not too far away in New York City. And playing in those pickup games is great experience for a young player.
2 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Stauffer. Buries it. Oh, and that is an enormous
damn.
And the Eagles
that is
that's
a big
here.
Shot.
Here's Junior.
It out.
Eagles are lucky to have Junior so ready to sacrifice himself on the drive against some stiff defense.
15 foul.
He knocks down the clutch free throw. Can't knock it down, and they really needed that one.
Miss it.
Even with the miss, he got the big one there to put them in front.
We won by one.
It is. The comeback is complete. What an amazing effort from the Newark East Eagles to fight their way back and steal a game that was lost at half.
Totally. Credit the fans for keeping the Eagles in this game, staying energetic. But the story of the game has to be Junior fighting his way through injury to lead his team in the second half.
I'll tell you what. The amount of heart that Junior showed in this game, the passion he played with when he clearly wasn't at his best,
look at
that's
that.
Something
look at
you rarely see
up.
In any sport.
Reminds you a bit of the passion his dad played
Where
with.
Where am I going to go, man?
Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Oh, man!
Yeah, baby.
God, I love watching this. Enjoy the moment, Junior. You'll never forget it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, thanks, Arch.
Now, remember. Rice it, okay? Yeah. Rest, ice, compress, and elevate the knee.
No doubt, all week, baby.
Hey. We focus on the invitation. That's all that matters now. Enjoy your night, baby. You earned it.
Thanks, Arch.
Remember, rice it.
I heard that so many times with my knee. My knee was fucked up all the time. It's crazy. This is a crazy story because my knee was fucked up all through high school. Draft stock just went way up.
Tell me what you know about a player.
Five star after that. Let's go. Let's do it. What we got next? What do we got next? Thank you guys for being here, man. Dude, yeah. NBA Jam and NFL Blitz, that shit. Oh. There's so many good sports games from back then. I wish like somebody would like make like an arcade remake of those where you could play them online with each other. How much fun would that be? But like Tecmo Bowl.
Woo!
Tecmo Bowl.
Food is everywhere. Oh, my man, Jimmy. He even got Big Liz up there. Evan, Chuck, a couple of heavy hitters in the NBA even getting an early look. Man, this all happened. How do you feel?
I'm good. Focus.
You look good, too.
You look stressed, Arch.
Those jerseys are pretty nice.
Well, that's okay, because I'm not playing. Look, a win would be ideal, but skills matter. You know, positive possessions, tempo, your demeanor in the warm-ups, your focus on huddles. Every player is an investment. They're going to be trying to get all kinds of intel to make sure you're a good fit.
Write that down. Bigger than Broadway. The Hendricks Cobb experience is about to light this city up.
Hendricks, have you narrowed down on any college selections? Or are you planning on jumping overseas? Hendricks.
Yo!
Of course it's happening.
I mean, I heard we was playing, but I had to come see it with my own eyes.
Yeah, it's good to see you, man.
Good to see you back playing. This is where you belong. On the court.
That's what's up,
well,
man.
At least he's your friend. New Orleans, though. Against you.
Home. It's good. I'm gonna hit shoot around.
All right.
See you on the floor?
Yep.
I know that's your friend and all, but you need to stay focused. You light him up and the world will open up for you.
All right. You need to reel it in now.
I'm serious.
Nah, I'm serious too, man. It's just...
I like this aspect because this is how it
right
actually
now, man,
is.
And I'm worried about you.
Ain't no vein in my neck bulging. How big is it?
Look, man, I'm just saying, you need to worry about your salt intake. That's all.
See, now you're pushing it.
I done played basketball before. I know what this game's about. I know how to win. As soon as that tip goes up, ain't no friends no more. Don't worry, Arch. I got it.
Let's go eat.
No. This room's for players and coaches only. Out.
Ah, it's okay. Coach, he's with me.
I know exactly who he is. Out!
Hey, come on now, don't hold back. Tell me how you really feel.
Is this funny to you?
No, it's not.
Whoa, what's going on?
But it's your show, right, Henry?
Yeah. What's he gonna owe you after all this?
Nothing. Nothing at all, Coach.
What's going on?
Have a great game, Junior.
Coach and our...
Thanks, Arch.
It's all up to you now.
Mentor.
We'll get him.
What is going on there?
So as I was telling you,
what is going on there? Oh, we're playing on Brooklyn 4.
Barclays Center. We're here for the final game in the Battle of Brooklyn. I'm Joe Lamy. Alongside me are Drake
Let's
Hugo
go.
And Jenny Hogger. Great matchup in this one between Louisiana Northeast and Newark East.
Sure is, Joe. Both teams have looked impressive lately, but you'd have to be a fool to think this isn't Louisiana Northeast to lose. They're led by top recruit Hendricks Cobb. This
Let's
team
go,
is
Cobb.
Tops in the country.
I'm hurt.
The
I'm
depth
hurt
and talent
you,
of the Civic Cats will be hard to match, but the Newark East Eagles are no slouches, and they played with heart all season long. They also have a surprise star in Junior that can provide matchup issues for the Civic Cats.
Either way, we'll be in for a treat as the top talent in high school hoops hits the floor. The scouts will be tuned in for this one as the Battle of Brooklyn is on its way. We see the Eagles starting with Day and Junior, the talented backcourt pair. On the wing, you have Lack, Zadirko, and Marceda make up the post pair to round out the starting five. For the Cats, it's the star tandem in the backcourt with Cobb at the one and Davidson at the two. Splitter fills in at the small forward position with the high-flying Teddy Edwards at the power forward spot, with Mushi Fresh rounding it out starting at center.
And regardless of what happens in this game, the Eagles have to be pleased with how this season turned out. Played
My
well
pants
above
fell
expectations
off. What's going on?
And find themselves playing in a top talent invitational.
It's stolen by Splitter. 2-on-0, no one back to stop it. And Splitter with the stuff.
You can tell Splitter is a disciplined player. On the fast break, he's right there to support the play and finish it strong.
And with Newark East, the improvement is what they're most proud about, Drake.
This was a defining season for the program. After having seasons where they looked lost, there's a renewed spirit for Newark East. This momentum should carry on well after this season.
Outside Cobb. Fresh, covered by Junior. Swings it to Splitter. And here is Edwards. There's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot, and he'll go to the line. That's on Zadirko. And only one injury to report for the Eagles in this one. Junior's still not at full strength.
The team was hoping that Junior's knee would have been fully healed by now, but it just hasn't recovered the way they wanted. He'll be available for them, but he isn't close to 100%. He might even be on a minutes restriction.
And here's Junior outside. And the miss there from Junior. Boy, he just doesn't look at full strength in this one.
Look how the Eagles rely on Zadirko. He always gives 110% on offense to keep the play alive and ensure they score.
Outside Cobb. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Back to Fresh. Fires for three. Newark East grabs the miss. Junior outside. And a tough start to this game for Junior.
No, you're right. Credit him for playing, but the way he started this game shooting the ball, you have to assume the knee is an issue. And it'll continue to be an issue for him all game long.
Here's Newark East. With the teardrop, Sheffield with the bucket.
Scouts have to love watching Sheffield get inside like this, proving just how effective he can be penetrating. Watching the way Cobb gets things done on the floor is exemplary. It's easy to see why he's such a highly regarded recruit.
Boring game so far, 4-2.
Just raw, natural ability combined with a great sense of the moment.
Making a desert.
Substitution on the court. Substitution on the court.
So it's the Cats now. It's a three-point game.
Oh, you're kidding me. I should have stole
covered by Junior.
So easy.
And the basket is good by Cobb.
Shrewd play by the Cats. Gets Cobb all set up. He seems very reliable when he can take the shot that he wants.
Pass to Junior. Not the best shooting night for Junior, and you wonder if his knee is the issue, guys.
He might not be making a big deal or show out of it, but the numbers say it's bothering him still. He just doesn't seem to have it tonight.
Here's Cobb. Yep, that one goes.
Masterful control. I love how Cobb accepts the contact and keeps his focus on the basket.
Playing hurt.
Here's Junior.
Are you kidding?
Here's Adirko. Louisiana with the board.
I can't hit any fucking layups.
Outside, Timmerman. Pass to Cobb. Splitter outside. Timmerman. Here's Cobb. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball.
How about a little bit of trivia? You talk to Hendricks Cobb, and he'll tell you a major figure in the development of his game was Duke, the father of Junior on the Eagles.
Yeah, Duke coach Cobb when he was coming
how
out.
How do I not knock that down? That was perfect.
Nice of Cobb to give credit to the late Duke.
Perfect timing.
You can see the precision in Cobb's game that Duke certainly played.
And then he hits that.
Doing much better now. First quarter, they converted less than 30% of their field goals, but they've bounced back here.
Junior, high post. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in this game from him. Takes a three.
How am I not
hitting
anything?
Junior looking a bit winded out there. Wonder if that injury is still bothering him. And even though he's out there and playing, Junior just doesn't seem like he's his usual self.
I would guess that he just doesn't have the same endurance as he normally does. I mean, he's moving fine, but everything seems to be a bit tougher for him tonight.
At Cobb's size, defenders have a really hard time creating solid coverage. He's already accustomed to shooting.
Need to play better right now.
And here are the Eagles now. They trail by one. They drive now by
Let's
Junior.
Go.
And
Let's
down
go.
It goes for two.
Impressive movement from Junior here, getting himself free to shoot. The Eagles really support each other on those plays.
Here's Cobb, and it's good for two.
And without a doubt, Hendricks Cobb, the number one recruit in the nation, we're seeing him tonight. A lot of eyes will be on him during this contest.
Here's Junior, and he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws coming up. And with Cobb, the number one prospect from this class, without a doubt. He's still undecided on where he's going to school, guys.
Yeah, and it's not from a lack of offers. Many major schools have reached out to him already. Cobb knows, though, he has all the power and will make his decision when he's good and ready.
That one is no good.
They should be in front right now. But he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty.
Splitter outside to the paint. And Teddy Edwards finishes it off.
This is good offense. Splitter giving it up to the open man. Scouts love to see it.
Newark East trailing. Here's Junior. The basket is good.
Nice take. However, a little too easy if you're asking me.
And here are the Civet Cats now. Splitter outside. For three, it's Hendricks Cobb. Another three for Louisiana.
When they've needed a bucket, he's provided it.
The drive by Junior. And the foul is called as he misses. He'll go to the line for two shots.
I like when Junior takes initiative. Being aggressive and getting the D to act on the drive.
And this is his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game here. For the Cats, this is more than just a road game for them. These young men are dealing with the first taste of play after traveling across the country.
Yeah, that should be a big advantage for the Eagles, Joe. They want to do whatever they can, keep their foot on the gas pedal.
Damn, he's just so quick.
Hopefully, that should even out the talent advantage that the Civet Cats have on paper.
Girth Burns is slow right now.
It's been a great start for this offense here in the second half.
Girth is hurt.
4-4.
Pass to Lack. Now here's Marceda. Here's Sheffield. Outside, Lack. Return to Sheffield. Marceda shoots over fresh. Marceda, good.
High IQ basketball from Sheffield. He gets himself an easy assist by feeding the wide open man.
Edwards outside. Pass to fresh. Able to recover.
Are you serious?
And the basket is good by Cobb.
They're riding his hot hand for all its worth.
Junior outside. Rebounded by Hendricks Cobb.
His shot has been way off, and it's certainly a reason as to why they're behind.
Shoots. And another basket for Louisiana.
And for Junior, the interest in him for colleges has been growing all season long.
Girth is so slow.
There's a good chance he'll get some offers from great schools to play at the next level.
And the Eagles will call.
Girth is hurt and he's slow.
First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. Junior inside. He's guarded by Wang. Here's Adirko. And the lead is down inside, single digits.
One of the many reasons Junior's teammates appreciate him. He's an unselfish player who likes setting his guys up well.
With some art. And the basket is good.
I thought I blocked him. Hit it.
With all the shots this offense has drained here in
Dude's
the second
beast.
Half, their field goal percentage has crossed the 50% mark.
And any team will take that. Excellent efficiency.
Check out Junior getting the best of the defense on that track. He's really learning how to apply his physical gifts.
Now here's Cobb. He's guarded closely. Just under 2.5 minutes gone by in the final quarter.
And he gets it to go.
He's a beast.
They try just about everything in the playbook on Cobb and cannot come up with a way to slow him down. I'd say he is 100% ready for the next level.
Outside, Lack. Back to Junior. Pass to Sheffield. Lack with it. Now Sheffield. Kicks it out to Junior.
There.
The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
And a look at the Civet Cats bench. It's not the most talented, but the group is well seasoned. A lot of seniors who have seen everything this program has thrown their way.
Cobb is definitely the superior player.
Cobb with it.
You gotta draft him.
And lots of contact there, missing the shot.
Dogs,
and we'll shoot two. It's going to be on Junior. And thinking about the Civic Cats bench, guys like Cepeda, Timmerman, and Wang, not very talented, but they're experienced.
I agree. Certainly they're the last guys you expect to do any real damage out on the floor, but they're really not known for their scoring. But that leadership, that experience that they provide, that secures their spot on this team.
Here's Junior. Gets a hand on it. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
The Eagles need this from Marceda at center. Fighting hard to win boards and finish the play strong.
A little over 3.5 minutes in the books now for this fourth quarter of play. Cobb got it. Good job right there.
This dude hits everything. I feel like I've done this season.
As flashy as Cobb is, of course he's going to have moves like that in his bag of tricks. He can never resist showing just a little bit of style.
And that one drops for him.
His passing is locked in, even when the man is in motion.
The Civet Cats with the lead. Now Splitter. On the wing, Hendricks Cobb. And Hendricks Cobb comes with the stuff. And as many expected, the Cats just too much to handle. Their loaded roster getting a big lead going here in the second half.
Girth is strong as fuck, buddy.
You can find an answer for Davis or maybe Edwards. You can't answer for
we'll
all
get them
of them.
In college.
That's when the Eagles are finding out, and tonight it's been all Civic Cats.
Mason outside. Pass to Indra. Junior. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew the contact on the shot. Foul on Bean.
Growing up in Newark has its perks. Junior got to hone his skills on the hard courts, not too far away in New York City. And playing in those pickup games is great experience for a young player.
Not as productive a trip to the line as he'd have liked. They need all their free throws to go down at this point.
Pass to Timmerman. Cepeda outside. Bean. Here's O'Gallagher. Covered by Junior. O'Gallagher misses.
Put a fork in them. Their comeback hopes are out the window. It's safe to say at this point.
Yeah, this deal, it's done. It's finished. It's over.
We got our asses whooped.
And that'll do it. Louisiana Northeast Civic Cats have won the Battle of Brooklyn. The top team in the nation looked the part as they took down several teams to come away with the invitational title.
Just exceptional. When you look at the talent that the Civic Cats have on their roster, it seems overwhelming this was going to be the case. The Eagles put up a fight, but Cobb and the rest of the Civic Cats were just too much for them.
And when it comes down to it, the Civic Cats were supposed to win this. That's the level of success they expect. The talent they have makes anything short of winning every game
now,
a failure.
Great set of games capped off by a fantastic.
I did Rain. Do a lot.
What can I say?
How about admitting that I'm better than you? Now that would be a good start.
I'm not going that far. Hey, you got me this time.
Hey, listen, man. You showed some to these scouts tonight. I know it. There will be others.
Celebrate with your teammates, man. You deserve it.
Well, celebrate? We a travel team, baby. We don't celebrate. It's just on to Cleveland.
So that was an AAU tournament? Kitty's going crazy. Come here, kitty.
Man, this is it. College.
1 month.
The atmosphere, the tradition, the coaching. It's nothing like it, Junior.
Come here.
This is a good time to get to know who
Come
you
here.
Are, too. Get an education, you know? I mean, there's no money right now, but the path gets easier for you to get a bigger brand once you get into the league because of all the TV exposure.
Yeah, like Zion.
Exactly, like Zion. It's not going to be easy. A few bad games gets magnified. Bad press snowballs fast in college.
Yeah, but positive press snowballs too.
Exactly. So you want to keep it
Gotta
positive.
Put Girth down now.
I know you made a few visits, talked to a few coaches.
Education.
But the the decision is yours. Where do you see yourself next year, Jaden?
We're gonna let his hair grow. Where are we going, guys? Michigan State, Texas Tech, West Virginia, Oklahoma, Gonzaga, Connecticut, Syracuse, Villanova, Florida, UCLA. We've got some major school. Michigan State, you got Tom Izzo. That's pretty dope. West Virginia would be cool. Gonzaga has a lot of awesome history. Connecticut's awesome. Syracuse is in New York. Villanova is in Philadelphia, and they're fucking... Villanova has been dope last couple years. Florida, obviously, has been awesome. UCLA is dope. What do you guys think? I don't know where my vote goes. It's so fucking dope. I like all of them. UCLA is kind of cool. Reggie Miller. Billy Donovan. I'm just saying the things I think of. UCLA is Reggie Miller. Lonzo Ball. I think of Billy Donovan. I think of Joakim Noah. I think of... let's play Jeff. You know, Joakim Noah had some ballers on that team. And Butler played against them. Bass's brother played against that Florida team. Bass's brother, Pete played against Joakim Noah, and Joakim Noah was at Florida. Villanova, Jalen Brunson, I think went to Villanova. Syracuse, Carmelo. Connecticut, fucking Kimball Walker. Gonzaga, the Lopez brothers. There's a lot of people went to Gonzaga. Oklahoma, you got Buddy Hield. West Virginia's dope just because it's West Virginia. Bob Knight coached at Texas Tech after IU. Michigan State, Tom Izzo. I'm leaning Michigan State or Gonzaga. Or Connecticut. Or Syracuse. I got a coin right there. I'm gonna flip coin. Okay, cool. What we're doing here. We're gonna make a bracket. Got Aga. We got Connecticut. We got Syracuse. What was the other one? Michigan State. Michigan. So, 2 out of 3. Each of them. For tails, we're just gonna like whatever's closer. So tails, G is closer. So tails is Gonzaga. C is Connecticut. Heads. That's Connecticut. Tails, Gonzaga. I dropped it. Lost the quarter. We lost it, guys. What? We really did lose it. Get a replacement quarter. Oh my gosh. It's 1-1. Tails. Guys. Tails. goes to Gonzaga. Next we have Syracuse and Michigan State. The S is closer, so Tails is Syracuse. We got Tails. And on the floor, what's on the floor? Are you serious? Are they going to an Oblivia? Oblivia? It's heads! It's heads! Michigan State! That 1-1, I think. I don't know. Here we go to decide everything. It's Syracuse. Got Syracuse against Gonzaga. All right. Syracuse is tails. Gonzaga is heads. Tails. We got one Syracuse. We're gonna go best of seven. Got a heads. 1-1. That one rolled under. Damn it. This is the deciding coin right here. This has been an absolute shit show. This is it. Gonzaga heads. Syracuse tails. It's a heads. Gonzaga. Gonzaga it is. Gonzaga. We're going to Gonzaga, and that's where it's at.
You made the right choice, Junior. Let's get you on a call with Coach. I know he's going to be thrilled. I'm going to be keeping an eye on you, you hear me? So you think you're ready to declare for the draft, just hit me up.
Thanks, Arch.
Moving into a bigger world now, Junior. You think you're ready?
Oh, no doubt, man. Let's forget it.
Get it. Take on it. I'm gonna go up top. I'm gonna let it shine. Make myself smaller. This love light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Light. Tell me what you know about a player. I came to game up. Man, I could have served. Instead, I served a base up. Sun beaming through the trees, driving down La Brea. Tires peeling at a screech, trying to. For now. Don't want to cover the screen, and I don't know. Need to figure out a good set with the 2K shit. Because the best place is always to put it at the bottom right, you know, right below us. But that's where the scoreboard is. That's not a good place for that. My gosh. The stream turned into a daggone shit show. I had already been drinking, but now drinking. Living and grinding, hustling it. From Gonzaga now, let's go. Hey.
Junior, Red. You guys ready? Excited?
100, coach. Don't know any other way.
Yes, sir. Can't wait.
Good. Like we spoke about in practice, conference is tough this year. We got high expectations in the media. But if we win more than we lose, we should be situated pretty well come tournament time. But tonight, it's Midnight Mania. All right?
Midnight Mania,
it's a celebration. Yeah. Everybody on this team has sacrificed a lot to get here, so you put on a show for those fans, all right? Enjoy it.
This is all, like, the students, hey, like, right
wanna,
when they get to campus.
Just this say
is,
this
like,
to you,
the coolest shit, dude. I went to it twice. We
father.
Called it Hoosier Hysteria.
Duke's leadership embodied everything college basketball is about.
And Hoosiers, baby.
Thanks, coach.
Have fun out there.
All the colleges, right when everybody gets to school, they have like a pep rally, but it's basketball, and they do like some contest, 3-point contest.
And we go bump. You go say stay hungry, and you're not feeling it.
Nah, man, I can't see myself committing to that.
Okay, okay. Open brainstorm is the first pass.
Nervous, Red?
I'm terrified.
It's gonna be all right, man.
I'm receiving your energy.
You are a weird dude, man.
Played a lot.
Stay humble, stay hungry.
Yeah, yes, sir.
All right, y'all. Let's bring it in.
Big girl.
Come on, y'all. Come on, come on. Talk to him, Red.
Hefty guard.
Y'all, I'm going to keep it short. Today sets the tone. So let's go out there and get these fans a season that they can look forward
He's
to,
a
okay?
Big man.
Break it down, Junior. Come on.
All right, y'all. Family on three. 1, 2, 3. Family.
Let's go. Court's bigger. I like it. Go and one. Hit it. Nice. This is how I was hoping to feel. I like this. Let's go. Let's go. like how the defensive era was way more responsive. It's more correct. I just noticed how that was a lot better in that path this year. And one. Let's go. To four, let's go. Oh, I got a foul. Get this over with. Come on. We beat the ass out of them. Good luck that they got the double digits. Do that every time. A little better, Jerry.
Sun beaming through the trees, driving down La Brea. Tires peeling at a screech, trying to go places. Rain hitting beats, I'm a hanging out my jeans, I'm a let them hate or play the game, it's a long way up. Trying to get my name up. Remember back when players used to rock these sweet CRs and big screen. Bright cars and long tees, wide bras and tight jeans. That was summer for me, counting Mississippi, down to the river, bound by a rhythm. Smile when I'm with ya, frown when I'm missing.
I'll go braid, no.
And this is real talk. I'm a real Brooklyn, this is real talk. I'm talking right by Lyndon Pace, this is real talk. I used to rock EVs with jeans, that's just real talk, real talk. This is real talk. I'm a real Brooklyn, this is real talk. You living life on the screen, that ain't real talk. Used to rocky V some jeans, that should tell me what you know about a player. I need hands in the air, 25, 8, I'm in a layer. Working off the wake up, man, I need a crib by a lake up. Lakeside crib by a lake up. Bodies hate us.
Make a real girth, let's make the real girth.
Save us from all the naysayers. Trying to figure out the flavor, where you stay at, where your grandma place at. Peace sake. Take shorty from the peach state, not from my state, like some cheesecake. Betty May, anime, pretty brown. We don't need her, we don't even, we so greedy. Sip on Fiji, treat them, then we leave it. Say la vie to stay that being. Tell her things I never mean and sell her dreams. Pick up the pieces, then I sleep on Tempur-Pedic. This is real talk. I'm a real Brooklyn. This is real talk. I'm talking right by Lyndon Pace. This is real talk. I used to rock EVs with jeans. That's just real talk. Real talk. Ooh. This is real talk. I'm a real Brooklyn. This is real talk. You living life on the screen. That ain't real talk. Used to rock EVs with jeans. That's just real talk. Now you know about a player. Class on my last name. My fashion and cash. Give me bags from the back. Chase imagine the last place. It could be ash. AM class. A relaxing. Came up from a bad space, I'm nasty. Can't stop until my name. Heavy chain, heavy everything. Heavy ring on my pinky thing. Heavy Wayne Gretzky skating on my necklace. Top five, still alive. Had to check it off the checklist. Tied out, laying things flat out. Now we, in case we take it that route. I'm just saying what you mean. No more playing around. Whole team getting green.
say what we about. Oh, whoa, whoa, understand I'm going beast mode. Try your chance on the plane with my amigos. Try again, flying JFK to Heathrow. Young and any healing from the East Coast, yeah.
Oh, wow, there's a lot of shit. What looks the most girth? I'm gonna go with that.
Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know what's up with you. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you comfortable. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know what's up with you. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you're comfortable. Oh. I found your vibe, and I found my, yeah. Let's touch the sky.
Do some shit, guys.
I'ma change your life, yeah. Do you realize I love the way you look me in my eyes, yeah. Don't kill my vibe, don't kill my vibe, yeah. On top of my game, we are the same, eh? I wonder why.
Everything up.
Think that they run things.
Everything up.
I wonder why, I wonder why, yeah. Just feel the vibes, just feel the vibes.
Let me know, let me know, let me know,
let me know. Let me know, let me know, let me
know. Let me know,
let me know, let me know, let me know.
Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me
know, let me know.
Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you comfortable.
Now when you left, it wasn't right, yeah. I took a left, swerved, and I took a right, yeah. I was feeling right, yeah, see it in the night air. They talking dumb, well, frankly, I don't care. Do you realize I'm the man and I'm in my prime, yeah? And it's my time, I swear to won't waste no time, yeah. You ain't worth a dime, no, you ain't worth a dime, yeah. Still on my mind, whoa, you still on my mind,
let me know,
yeah.
Let me know, let me know, let me know what's up with you. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you comfortable. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know what's up with you. Oh. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know if you comfortable. I wonder why.
Everything big.
I wonder why.
Everything big.
Just feel the vibes. Just feel the vibes. I wonder why. I wonder why. Just feel the vibes.
Everything big.
Just feel the vibes. I wonder why. I wonder why. Just feel the vibes. Just feel the vibes.
We gotta think of original girth, like just to start girth.
Everything big.
That's him. That's him. Late second round pick, are you kidding me? Girth is way better than that. Still have money. I wish you would be faster. I wish there was just a, like, a quickness. Driving down Target, baby. I'm gonna go through. Thinking about just making my free throw all the way up. Yeah, 75. 80. Oh, I'm gonna steal all the way up. I'm just gonna go steal all the way up. No, we're not. I'm gonna go steal 70. That's all we're gonna do. Let's go. Let's rip, fools.
Boom! Okay, you know, that boom feels like a little much. You win every time. Well, then maybe winning should feel like less of an event.
Every time feels like the first time.
Boom!
Yo, y'all up for some doubles?
Hey, yo, Lula, no, I'm not good at this game.
Yeah, let's go, let's go. I'm always ready to take the basketball team down a peg.
Why you say that?
Okay.
Because, you know.
I don't. Do you?
Yeah, they think we walk around like we own the place.
Because everyone treats you like you do. Boom!
Yo, I told you I was bad at this game. Now I'm starting to live up to it.
All right. I don't act like that.
Because you're new. You'll change.
Wait, you act like that, right?
Not yet, but apparently it's fate. But who am I to argue with fate?
Boom!
Oh,
oh,
come
God,
on,
I
man.
Love
doing
game.
That.
Yes.
All right, look. Serious.
Big game coming up, boys. First game, right? You nervous?
Yeah. College is a new game. It's a big step, but my dad taught me to respect it.
Oh, Ellie, hey, we gotta get to practice.
Oh, that's because I was winning. You wanted to walk out like that?
What's your name?
Junior. Hey, what if we win this next game and me and you do something together?
Uh-oh.
And if you lose?
Then we don't.
Text me after your game.
You just got to say something. Ellie.
Shit. They happen. Things happen right then. Here we go.
Welcome, everyone, to our presentation of college basketball. We have what promises to be a great game ahead of us. In this game, we'll see the West Virginia Mountaineers going up against the Gonzaga Bulldogs. Along with analysts Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, I'm Forrest Hunt. Tonight, we get a look at some of the next generation of NBA stars.
You know, that's one of my favorite parts of watching these games, seeing what kind of dynamic, new, fresh players will soon be headed to the league.
Yeah, plenty of NBA hopefuls on these two teams. It'll be interesting to see who really distinguishes themselves from the pack. Showing he has the ability to read a defense. Junior, fantastic pass to set up a teammate.
West with it. He's against Thompson. West, he's covered by Thompson. Now here's West. likes to shoot. Let's it go. And Benjamin pulls it down.
And a freshman out of California, guard Red Thompson. Not a major recruit by most listings, but he can play. Another solid young option for this team.
Outside West. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots coming up. And Thompson a bit flighty on the court, or at least that's the scouting report. But which freshman players aren't like that?
You know, the coaching staff sees something in him, and they might be on to something here. You look at Thompson. They were very excited to add him to the list of incoming freshmen. I think he'll be a big part of what this program does and becomes the next couple of years.
Pearson outside. Here's Harden. Off target from outside. Thompson inside. He's guarded by West. And it's Red Thompson with the jam.
And guys, you can tell he's one of the more expressive players on the team. I think I know what Let's Thompson go. Wanted to say with that dunk.
Let's go.
Now here's West. He's covered by Thompson. Outside West. Harden. Pass to Pearson. Misses the layup. Gonzaga, without a doubt, is a basketball school. The fans up in Spokane love their Bulldogs.
You know, Gonzaga does not sponsor a ton of athletic teams, and there's no football there either, so basketball is indeed king. Clearly, all of the support that goes to the athletic program is prioritized with basketball.
Gonzaga leading. And it's blocked by West. And he's able to get it back. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Boy, Pearson not lacking for confidence. He has full belief in his ability to knock down that outside tray. Dangerous from deep.
Here's Junior. It's good, and he makes his first shot of the game.
Beautiful.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Side West. Pass to Harden. And he knocks the jumper down. Now Junior. Crawford. He's guarded by Stevenson. Junior with the bucket.
I tell you what, fellas, we're seeing some really good ball movement out there.
Definitely. 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists. And what a powerhouse program Gonzaga has built here. Little by little, they have established themselves as a major player in college hoops. Easily the biggest name college program in the Northwest.
Back to West. 5 o'clock. For three, Torres pulls it in. And they're running. Pass to Crawford.
Beautiful.
Yes, and it's Junior picking up the assist.
Beautiful.
I love the unselfishness.
Be in the right spot.
And you know coaches do as well.
Yeah, it sure has been. I mean, all you have to do is look at the numbers.
4, 5, 3, you kidding me? You kidding me? You're showing everyone.
Outside West, pass to Harden, and there it is for him. And Gonzaga, you guys, has gone from scrappy underdog to an absolute force. They are an elite program.
For years, Gonzaga has been unchallenged in conference, but absolutely dominating the conference they play in. And, you know, this school has always had a great record and is not afraid to schedule tough. I think all of that is why Gonzaga has been so successful. You can just about count on one former Bulldog joining the league every draft. Man, Gonzaga's got an impressive roster of NBA players.
All time, the big name is John Stockton. More recently, Rui Hachimura and Domantas Sabonis. Some great talent always finds their way to Gonzaga.
Pass to Torres. His first shot coming late. Stevenson with the rebound.
Nobody even close to him, and he can't believe he doesn't knock it down.
Here's Brand. Here's Harden. Block at six. Here's Weaver. The Mountaineers rebound. A nice shot by Harden.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside.
Yeah,
the rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, impressive effort from both on the backboard.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. That one on West.
Always a good idea to go up strong inside. Junior draws contact and gets to the line.
He's perfect from the line this time. The Mountaineers trail.
You know, you look at the tournament history for the Bulldogs. Early on, they were always underdogs under this coaching staff. But now, they're usually a top seed in the tournament.
Here's West. And it's Gonzaga with the rebound.
Get in.
Here's Thompson.
Good. Nice.
And the assist goes to Junior.
Nice shot against tough defense. Thompson actually gets hit on the way up, but able to maintain that concentration.
Back to West. And Benjamin pulls it down.
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely gets in your head.
Well, they say you should shoot your way out of it, but his teammates probably have other thoughts in mind.
Boom.
The last thing they want to see him doing is continuing to cast that jumper up.
Now here's West. Defense right on him. Pass to Weaver. Fires it. And the Mountaineers miss again.
You know, the fact is, he's not a lock from there, but he was open enough to where he should have hit that shot.
And the first.
That's the first shot. Are you kidding me? You know, 8-3-6. 8-3-6.
And through the first half of play, what about Junior's performance stands out?
Thus far, an excellent caretaker of the rock. He's finding his teammates and still yet to turn the ball over.
And, you know, the turnover number can often be overlooked. Protecting the possession, pivotal in a game that so often comes down to the slightest of margins. You know, they've come close on a few occasions in the past, but West Virginia is still looking for its first title. In 1959, they were runners-up, and they made the Final Four in 2010.
Drive by Junior. No good there. And the Mountaineers going the other way now. Fires the three. And again, West Virginia with the triple. For the Mountaineers, they are rarely a high seed. They've never been a number one seed.
They were a two seed in 2010 and a three seed in 2016. Other than that, they are usually not ranked that high. But they're building something here, and they're pushing for that first title.
Now here's West, covered by Junior. West with it. He has seven. And yep, that's good.
That makes three in a row to start the second half.
Gonzaga leading. Junior outside. And then Crawford with the dunk.
Easy. I'm getting double.
And here is Pearson. He's got nine. Outside West. Back to Pearson. Pass to Stevenson, and he's way off from outside.
And you know, the freshman from Newark, they call him Junior, He was a football player for a few years, but then switched to basketball his senior year in high school. Getting an invite to play with this program seems like a good switch for him.
Wow.
Pearson outside. Now here's West. So he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two. And you see the talent that Junior already has. It makes you wonder why he didn't switch from football.
Yeah, the game. We got 5 minutes. Let's go. We're up by one. 8-8.
Now here's Lovins. Now Junior. Inside. Crawford. Score the basket. It's
He's
number six
Crawford's
for him in the game. 6 for 9 at 67%.
Feed the beast.
Here's Pearson. Pass to Weaver. Back to Pearson. Hernandez. Pearson outside. Here's Tavares. Now Pearson to tie. With the rebound. Well, this marks the first contest with the school for Junior. He hasn't been playing organized ball for too long, but he has learned very quickly.
Hey, there's no denying it. He's a bit raw, without question, but the coaching staff thinks he'll improve rapidly. The athleticism and the skill, evident and obvious, just a matter of time before he smooths it out. You got to remember now, he only played 1 year in high school.
The Mountaineers making a switch here.
Well, he did enough there. He made it a two-possession game, at least.
Pearson with it. Junior's there.
Perfect.
Good.
Perfect defense.
Hey, if you're defending a guy like Pearson, you can't let
Perfect
him hurt you
defense.
Inside. You got to push him farther away.
Plenty of drama so far in this one.
Yeah, don't be surprised if it isn't decided until the final buzzer.
Back to Junior. It's
Are
held in by Harden.
Kidding? No one was contesting.
And the Mountaineers with possession. Pearson outside to take the lead. Good for another field goal. Number 5 of the night. He's shooting 50%.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Well, it's been a 3-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
Junior guarded by Pearson. Torres outside. Thompson. And it's going to be 2 free throws, drawing the contact on the shot.
Tied up.
And you guys, Junior being named a starter for this team right off the bat, did that catch you off guard, or did you see that coming?
Well, there isn't a doubt that Junior will be great eventually. There's an argument to be made that he should have been eased into big minutes, but Coach trusted the impact that Junior has on the floor from the get-go.
Here's Harden. Pearson outside.
We got
back to West. 6 on the shot clock. Kicks out to Pearson.
No.
The 3 is up. And the Mountaineers, another 3.
They've been splashing home those 3 since halftime.
Market improvement in their shooting from what we saw to start the game.
Let's go.
West with it. And here's Thompson. Here's Junior.
Bang!
By Junior.
And at the college level, Junior has really
Let's
stepped
go.
Up and shown us what he can do. Here he
go.
It's big points to help rally his team.
Pass to Harden. Holds up. High post. And it's Gonzaga with the rebound. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. with the best college players often leaving without playing the full 4 years, it's always interesting how much teams change year to year.
Hey, college stars are like shooting stars. Blink and you'll miss them. It's definitely one of the most interesting challenges of the college game for coaches.
Absolutely. I mean, coaches have to constantly adapt to new rosters. They're more focused on getting the best pieces to fit their strategy rather than recruiting guys to build a strategy around.
Now here's West. Back to Stevenson. Outside, West. Pearson outside to halt the run. And again, it's the Mountaineers missing.
You know, to cut deficits, you got to be making smart basketball plays out there. Taking care of the ball. It's not done by hoisting up bonehead threes like that.
Thompson outside. Junior. And now we've got the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six.
You know, what I like most about Junior is how he stays confident, composed, and focused. I mean,
beautiful,
even when he's going through a tough stretch, for a young player that's just developing,
first game,
he's got a lot of self-confidence.
In college basketball, rankings are everything. Do you guys have a preference between a scrappy underdog or a dominant top seed?
I got to go with that powerhouse top seed team. There's a reason those teams earn that ranking through the course of the regular season.
I love the unpredictability of these games. Always fun to see an underdog team defy expectations and grab the W. Big time shot from Pearson. Moments like this prove why he's out there in these situations.
And no good this time on the one-and-one opportunity. And so they'll choose to intentionally foul. And no good on the one-and-one.
They've got to take the first good shot they can find.
A quick score, Greg, and then probably foul him right away.
Here's West. Here's Harden. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And Gonzaga gets called for the foul. Good on the first. And that narrows the lead down to just three. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
They really had to have those free throws. It's down to a one possession lead.
And they go to the intentional foul. He gets the first. And that makes it a three-point lead.
Yeah, you know, for a young fella, I think Red's in a really perfect situation. I mean, he's got a nice complimentary player in Junior, so I really think it's important for a developing player to have somebody like that to grow with.
And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game out.
Exactly. I mean, got to stop the clock any way possible and hope they alligator arm a few of those free throws. Outstanding work at the foul line to make this a two-possession game.
Pearson outside. Brand covered by Torres. West can't hit. And he commits the intentional foul.
No intentional foul, dude. Come on.
He hits the first one, and that increases their lead to six. And so we get some both, and it's a seven-point game.
A plus, so it's 13 points, 11 assists.
God, one of the keys to their effort, I think, was the passing of Junior. Outstanding awareness and vision on display all game long.
And it's such an infectious way to play. He has the athleticism to take over a game single-handedly, but he'd rather bring his teammates along for the ride.
And that concludes our broadcast. Thanks for being with us. Catch you next time.
guy, though. He's like, nothing happened. He just runs away. I'm good. Picked him up and accidentally bumped into his head on the table right here. He's just like, nope, nope, we're good. We're good. Everything's good here. Let's dominate that game up. Dominate.
Good win, Junior.
Now all I'm focused on is getting us to the tournament.
Hey, that's why we brought you here. Play the game the right way.
We got green hair, apparently. Really, I didn't mean to do that.
He's leader right now. All right.
Hey, very green.
This team will go as far as you take us. I'm going to need you to own that, all right?
Yes, sir.
Good job.
Thanks, coach.
He does have the Girth look. It's Girth Burns, yo. So, flashing lights and I pose on a road to give you my soul. Dearly, I love you. Never been on my level. Can I pick up the place? Tell me when and where.
My money is these
racks. I'm gonna ruin every next game. Stay tuned.
My coach,
oh shit.
Nothing really. He likes what we're at.
Those numbers up in your draft position gonna be sitting pretty too, alright?
I'm saying you wanna play on a higher level, right? I don't care if it's football, basketball, anything. I don't even care if it's one of the top leagues. We're still talking about all-stars from every state, every country for the last 15 years. There is no let up. You gotta be ready for that.
Man, what makes you think I'm not ready?
Just asking me that question tells me you're not ready.
Because I'm not afraid enough.
That's better as a start. That's right, because outperforming just your teammates, that's not going to cut it no more, right? What happens when you feel overwhelmed? Because that's going to happen. What happens when you feel like it's just not clicking? What do we do then?
Work when you're on the clock. Yeah,
Topa.
Work.
Thank you. Topa's okay, so you kitty. Do listen sometimes.
Yeah, here.
All right, not wasting my time. Look, son. Good to see you, dude. Respect.
He's a cool cat.
Look. Your ceiling is sky high. I believe in you with everything I got, but you gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe in your talents. You gotta show commitment if you wanna cash in on this.
I am committed.
All right, I believe that. I believe that. I also know there's always more for us to do. Always. Let's go.
Okay. Late second round, are you kidding me? For Apple Pops? My animations is kind of important. Change my jump shot. James jump. Perfect. Do that for now. Damien's jumper is perfect. Late second round, you kidding me? We had a double-double, 13 points, 11 assists, our first fucking game in college. You kidding me?
Welcome, everybody, and thanks for joining us tonight for our presentation of college basketball. And tonight, we'll see the Syracuse Orange as they go up against the Gonzaga Bulldogs. Here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, I'm Forrest Hunt, looking forward to a hard-fought contest in this one.
Well, you know, that's Syracuse, the beauty of college basketball in my mind. These players have so much youthful exuberance, they can go all out for every game of the season. And because the season's not as long, that plays into it as well.
Yeah, the stamina of a lot of these younger guys can seem bottomless, which only makes these games even more exciting to watch.
Out of bounds, orange ball as Syracuse keeps possession. Wolf, covered by Torres. Five on the clock. Here's Miller. And it's off the back rim. No good.
Here's Junior. And it's going to be two free throws, drawing the contact on the shot. It's going to go on Miller.
You know, one thing that Syracuse has really contributed to basketball is their zone defense. As a matter of fact, it's hard to watch a team play 2-3 zone and not think about Syracuse. They've played that defense effectively for as long as Boeheim has been the coach there.
For a long time, it was a hallmark of the Orange. The 2-3 zone forces teams to beat you from the outside as they crowd the paint. The Orange made it successful by closing out quickly on the shooters and never giving up those easy shots.
That one falls.
Let's get it.
You know, I love seeing guys knock down the mid-range shot, and Torres has kept that shot alive in his arsenal.
Pass to Wolf. Now West. James, covered by Crawford. The tray. And it's Miller missing. Torres outside. Back to Junior. Out to the right wing. The shot that time, not on target. Good work defensively by Starks. Inside, James, and he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
And that's a good glimpse of Kai's tremendous court vision. Sees the open man and gets it to him before the D has a chance to react. It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Well, I really like the package that Red Thompson has. He's not really flashy, but uber effective. He's a combo guard, has a real nose for scoring, can knock it down from outside or attack the rim effectively.
Now here's Miller over Junior. They get it again. They shoot again. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots coming up. First trip to the line for him in this one. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. Speaking of Thompson, he doesn't give you much on defense, but his offense is the selling point.
His defense should improve, but you can live with where he's at. Fortunately, he more than makes up for it with his skill set on the offensive end. He's a natural shot creator for himself as well as for others.
Thompson, and he's good on the three ball.
Boy, big three-point bucket that time from Thompson. And that kind of accuracy from beyond the arc makes him an attractive NBA prospect.
Outside, Starks. Back to Miller. Here's the three. Red Thompson with the rebound. Gonzaga in the lead. Junior with it. Picked up by West. Pass to Crawford. Good. And the assist goes to Junior.
Syracuse has one title to its name, but a lot of near misses, too. Clearly, you look at the tournament history for the Orange, a lot of highs and lows for sure.
Here's Wolf. West with it. Outside, Starks. West. Now Miller. Pass to Starks. To the middle. Here's West. Good, unable to end this run. You guys, the Orange also winning some titles before there was a standardized tournament.
The school has claimed to be the champions in 1918 and 1926. That might be when the school fell in love with the hardwood. They've had plenty of runner-up finishes and semifinal exits in their storied history.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's Dennis. Bulldogs with the rebound. Here outside, Junior. And he gets the bucket.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
It really has, Mark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of dealing with their passing.
And the Bulldog. Here's Crawford. And the three ball is good.
But, you know, he's one of the greatest players of all time as a former Bulldog. And I'm speaking, of course, of John Stockton, the Hall of Famer. He helped put this program on the map.
Stockton was dominant at the college level as a senior. Led the conference in points, assists, and steals. It's not a surprise that his was the first number to be retired by the program.
Gonzaga on D. Outside, Nelson. And again, it's the orange missing. The Bulldogs on offense. 11-point game. Junior with the bucket.
The assist totals just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
And they're running. The basket good off the assist from Thompson.
Getting it done on both ends, and it shows up in the score.
And they're doing it at both ends of the floor. I mean, that's what you like to see. They've been controlling the action from both ends of the court.
Now here's West. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And Thompson gets it to go.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist. Well, for a long time, Syracuse has been a major player in college hoops. They've been a tough competitor since the 70s. Very rarely will they not be a presence in the tournament at the end of the season.
Here's Wolf. I can do what I want.
Pass to West. Down to five on the shot clock. And again, it's the orange missing. Here's Junior. Syracuse with the rebound. Here's Wolf. The shot to stop the drought. That one a little long.
Well, it's hard to believe that we're at this point in the game and he still hasn't registered a single point offensively.
Wow.
He can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
A challenging stretch for Syracuse here. Outside, Nelson. Pass to Wolf. And here's Starks. Covered by Crawford. Up top, West. Shot clock at six. West with another miss.
Oof, this has been brutal. I mean, he still hasn't made a single shot. No wonder.
Damn, I want to hit three so bad.
Here's Wolf. Gets it off. No good on the buzzer beater. And so a pretty lopsided game through the first half. And through the first half of play, what about Junior's performance stands out?
Thus far, an excellent caretaker of the rock. He's finding his teammates and still yet to turn the ball over.
And, you know, the turnover number can often be overlooked. Protecting the possession, pivotal in a game that so often comes down to the slightest of margins. I don't think there's any question about it. Carmelo Anthony, clearly the most famous Orange graduate, but you know what?
Bingo.
There have been a fair amount of NBA players that have come from that program as well.
Syracuse will usually have a player or two that could play at the next level. Often they'll recruit players who will be great in college, and a lot of their best players have stuck around for 4 years because of that.
Now here's Miller. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. That shot, no good. And it's Gonzaga the other way.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be.
Firmly
in control of this game.
And no doubt about it, rebounding is an effort stat, folks. They've been more determined than their opponent thus far.
Pass to Wolf. Now West. Outside Miller. Back to West. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two here.
And because...
Pass to Levins.
Back to Junior.
You know, you look around the landscape of college basketball, and Gonzaga was clearly a trailblazer as far as mid-majors go. I mean, we're talking about one of the most feared mid-major schools in the country, and it's been that way for a couple of decades.
And stolen by Junior.
What is this? Reverse from there? A one-handed scoop.
Oh my goodness, what a slam from Junior. Where did that come from?
I did not expect to see that tonight. That was a dunk contest level throwdown there.
He pulled that out of nowhere. That's going to be on highlight reels for years.
Back to Dean. Nelson. Pass to James. Shot and stolen by Levins. Here's Hawkins. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range, even against that length.
You know, guys, if they're inside, that shot probably gets blocked. But from mid-range, I mean, he's able to get it off over the bigger defender there.
I love our team.
Pass to Miller. Here's James. Just five on the clock. Now Dean, the three. Jameson grabs the board. Junior drives in. Nelson
foul.
With a block.
Foul, sir.
And guys, Junior is as raw of a player as they get. He didn't start playing organized ball until recently, but this program believes in him.
And you know, he only played his senior year of high school as far as basketball goes, but that was enough to impress this coach to offer him a spot on the team. And you can see the raw athleticism and the skills are starting to come along nicely too.
Now Junior, 13 points in the game.
And
it's
good,
dude. Fought through the contact, hit the shot, and he'll go to the line. He's gone 3 for 4 from the line. And that one misses.
You know, what I like most about Junior is how he stays confident, composed, and focused. I mean, even when he's going through a tough stretch, for a young player that's just developing, he's got a lot of self-confidence.
Back to Nelson. Wolf. Pass to James. Nelson with it. Here's James. Looking to end the run. Jameson grabs the board.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one. It's all about keeping one's balance, like watching Junior accept the hit and still be able to finish.
Given how players come and go from college teams, the only real consistency we get year to year are the coaches.
Well, you know, that and the mascots. But absolutely, for a lot of these teams, coach is kind of the de facto star. And given how rapidly the lineups change, it's really a unique challenge to succeed as a coach at this level because of all the roster turnover every couple of years.
I have to agree with that. You're constantly reshaping your approach in reaction to your latest recruits and losses. It's an impressive balancing act they have to pull off.
And it's Miller missing.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it, gritty and rough. But that's how you win games.
The outside, Nelson. Pass to Miller. Wolf. And here is Dennis. Here's James. Over Crawford. Here's Miller. Drops in the layup for two.
You've got to box out on the boards. When you don't, that's what happens.
It's stolen by Dennis.
Damn it.
It's Nelson on the wing.
over to the left wing. A big part of what elevates the excitement of these college games has got to be the diehard fans who are so unrelenting in their support of their teams.
You got that right. These crowds stay amped up for the entire game. The dedication of these fans is truly second to none.
Yeah, you know, these fans will do about anything to fire their teams up and give them an edge. That's why a lot of these schools really literally think of their fans as the sixth man.
So it's Syracuse with it.
Points. Let's go.
They're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Pass to Jackson. Powers. Here's Olsen. Down low. Here's Jackson. Can't connect from short range.
Just tentative in the paint, lacking a little bit of confidence, allowed the defender to recover and contest that shot.
And there it is for him.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
And, you know, the lead just keeps growing. I mean, this game is not going to get out of their grip. They're going to keep pulling away.
Three-pointer. Powers can't hit. Junior, right side.
And one.
Syracuse with the rebound. The spectacle of college basketball is certainly one of its big draws. These young athletes are giving 100% effort for every minute of the game.
That's why I think you get such an exciting pace for these
That's
games
a foul, sir.
At this level. These players are really hungry to go out there and prove themselves on the big national stage.
Yeah, every player on the floor is looking to have a career-making performance. Who knows? Could be some NBA scouts out there in the crowd tonight.
30 points.
Now here's Junior. To the paint. It's Keefe on the wing. Back to Junior.
Foul, sir.
Jackson grabs the board.
Foul, sir.
So it's Syracuse with it. Here's Olsen. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Keith with the defensive effort. Junior with it. The layup off target. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Powers. Rebound by Keith.
And I'm sure next time he sits down, coach is going to have a few choice words for him with that shot selection.
Yeah, there were a lot of other places he could have gone with the basketball instead of forcing that shot up.
Now here's Junior. He's closely guarded. And it's in after the nice bounce off the right iron.
Look out now. Junior is hot and feeling it right now.
So no problem for Gonzaga as they get the win.
And the strong performance from Junior, a big reason they won it going away. He never let up on the gas pedal. Pedal to the metal by Junior.
And that's the killer instinct that teams are looking for at the next level. With performances like this one, definitely improving his draft stock, if you ask me.
And that concludes our broadcast. Thanks for being with us. Catch you next time.
Mid-second round, that's it. Yep. You kidding me? I'm going to play a song and take a pee, smoke a cigarette, and I'm going to be back. We're going to play more games, no
Junior,
doubt.
Why'd you dunk the ball like that?
After this.
I saw an opportunity to make a big play. Hey, why'd you dunk the ball like that? Felt like the right time to energize the team.
Why'd you dunk the ball like that?
All right, you're gonna have to make a decision about what type of player you're gonna be, how you're gonna represent yourself and this school. Would your dad have made that play?
Your daddy do.
Listen, coach, if I stepped out of line and you don't want me to
What would your daddy do?
No, daddy, no!
I can make the adjustment.
What would your daddy do, Girth?
I can feel it down in my plums.
All right, now I'm at my school. I'm bleeding our colors, but I lived on the bench. One particular game, everybody was in foul trouble, so I get tossed in. Now I'm thinking, good, it's my moment. I'm gonna give him the razzle dazzle, behind the back pass, crossover, step back. I think
for real, what you've been hassling about?
Absolutely, I wanted to show that I belonged in the rotation and off the bench. We ended up winning by 2, so I'm thinking I'm on cloud 9. Life's complete.
Why do I get the feeling that this story does not have a happy ending?
Well, Coach pulls me aside and he tells me I'm back on the bench. He says we should have won by 10, but I made the game about myself, my ego. Every time I went, I wanted to do something special or fancy, we dropped possessions. I was mad. He was wrong. But then I saw the tape. You know what happens next, or you're just tired of listening to me talk?
I'm mad because I'm listening, Coach.
Look, Junior, win or lose, play the game the right way. Now, if you think that dunk was the right play, that's fine, but you're going to have to live with that, and there may be some unintended consequences. You got me?
Got you, Coach.
All right.
Smiling, huh?
Hey, don't worry about that.
Oh, she got it. She's smiling. Man. Look you at go. You, boy.
Hey, thank you for bringing me here. This place is amazing.
I come here every Monday when Madison's playing. So easy to get one-dimensional with, like, everything that we do. Like, training and film sessions
just
and travel.
Weird, Bastian.
I just want to see so much that's out of that bubble, you know? Like, yeah. I have to.
Yeah. Well,
Burns is good, dude.
No? Why not?
Burns is a beast.
That is a great question, especially because it's so direct.
Well, that's what college is for, right?
Yeah.
Figuring out who you are, and you're exposed to so much, just if you're open to it. Like, all of this makes me so good at soccer in the long run. Like, at least I like to think it does.
And you play for the Canadian national team, too?
I'm an alternate right now, but time I get in line and they sing, "Oh, Canada," I get chills. Like, I can't wait. School lets me take assignments on the road as a special arrangement.
Hold on. If my memory serves me correct, you said basketball players get the treatment.
Yeah.
That's what you said, right?
Yes.
Basketball.
Yeah, I did.
Okay,
I did,
checking.
Okay?
I'm just checking.
But you know what I'm saying, right? Right?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, it's 2K.
Everywhere I go, people are asking me about the games, win or lose.
Especially lose.
Yeah. Expectations are high. Yeah, I get it. I mean, the fans.
Whatever.
Everything's so personal.
Oh my God, yes. Yeah, it's hard to filter out all that noise.
Who the heck do you think you are?
Yeah, I struggle with it sometimes.
Being good at this, it's a responsibility.
Yeah, it's just all going by so fast.
Get real!
And I just want to appreciate this moment. So thank you very much.
Why don't you do it?
Thank you, too.
There's tension in the air. I can feel it.
I can feel it down in my plums.
Mid-second round pick, that's fucking bullshit. Gonna get to the first pick. Our money on
though. I think he's the most important.
You know Alex Williams, Airball Alex Williams. You don't know her show, bro? What?
Should I?
Yes, she's one of the top national college basketball influencers. She's blowing up with a dope blunt podcast and video channels. You gotta take it seriously, cause them NBA draft heads definitely do.
All right, I'll check out.
No. You gonna do it now because she's all over you. Right here, she singled you out and issued a challenge. Throw down. And she even hit me on my socials to make sure you got it.
Let me see that. Okay.
20 so points and a W? 20 sure points and a W, I got this.
And if I don't?
She'll bury you. I seen it happen before, stone cold ruthless.
All right, fine. She wants to go, we can go. I ain't never been afraid of no challenge.
Welcome, everybody, to College Basketball presented by 2K Sports. This should be a fun one. In this game, we'll see the Gonzaga Bulldogs going up against the Villanova Wildcats. I'm Forrest Hunt, along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we are just as excited as you are to see what this game has in store.
One great thing about college basketball, anything can happen. Scouting reports and standings are all well and good, but it's really a surprise every time.
Absolutely. I mean, these players are all improving. At a rapid rate at this stage of their careers, and because of that, you can never count out an underdog.
Watson misses. Junior with it. Now guarded by Charles. Drive by Junior. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two here. It's on Charles.
As they say on the playground, I ain't scared. Junior taking it hard to the bucket. No fear in that young man.
And so he makes both from the line. Here's McCarthy. Outside, Watson. Pass to Charles. Here's McCarthy. Now Watson. To the inside. Charles. That shot off the mark. Good D by Junior. Villanova, part of the Philly Big Five. One of five schools in Philadelphia that is a hotbed for basketball talent.
You think about the Big Five schools that reside in the Philadelphia area, and Villanova clearly has had the most success. Philadelphia is a great hotbed of basketball and recruiting. I tell you what, that whole area loves the sport, and there are always terrific players in the city.
Now here's Charles. Shot clock at six. Outside, Watson. Off target from outside. Junior outside. Thompson. Back to Junior. And a great assist by Thompson as that one goes in.
When he makes a catch and fire, Junior shows the confidence he's gaining in that shot.
Blocked Hoffman with the bucket.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
Take it away, take it away.
Now here's Junior. Charles defending. Good on the bucket.
Showing he has the ability to read a defense. Junior, fantastic pass to set up a teammate.
The three from Watson. That does not fall. Still looking for his first basket after three shots.
You know, currently they're just 1 of 5 from the field. That's not going to get it done. Well, you look at the players that have been able to come out of Villanova and go on to successful pro careers. Really impressive. And I think it's a credit for the way the coaches teach the game and hold the players accountable. They're pro ready when they get done playing at Villanova.
Now here's Blackman. Up top, Charles. Back to Blackman. Chuck up two there. There have been plenty of recent Wildcats in the NBA, you guys. Jalen Brunson, who won the AP Player of the Year Award with Villanova.
Guys like Eric Paschal, Omari Spellman, still have stars like Kyle Lowry going strong as well. Some great players have come through this school.
This is his second trip to the line in the game.
You know, what I like most about Junior is how he stays confident, composed, and focused. I mean, even when he's going through a tough stretch, for a young player that's just developing, he's got a lot of self-confidence.
Pass to Blackman. Knocked away. And the foul called on Junior. To the middle. Up top, Blackman. McCarthy. He's covered by Thompson. Pass to Justice. And here's Fisher. Watson with it. Clock at 6. The second chance effort. Not gonna go that time. Now the Bulldogs take it the other way.
And you think back to that first title run of the Wildcats. Went all the way in 1985. They were an 8 seed in what was a magical run for the Wildcats.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Pass to Justice. 2 points. That one goes in.
You have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent passing.
And that 1985 team capped off with one of the biggest upsets ever.
When they won it all, they completely shook up the world with that upset. I mean, it's something that we still talk about today. What a great moment for Villanova and really for all of college sports.
Good job getting the ball and completing that play.
Well, there's not much defense available once a steal is made. That's the best time to attack on the break.
So it's the Wildcats now. 11-point game. Outside, Watson. Fisher. Here's Justice. And even after 2 offensive rebounds, they just can't take the lid off.
Well, they've only got a slight edge in rebounding when you look at the numbers, but it certainly feels a lot bigger than it is.
Yeah, the score has a lot to do with that. Their overall effort and execution has been elite.
Watson, unable to get that one to go. And it's Gonzaga the other way. You guys, many are wondering if Junior is stepping into a leadership role with this team. The fans feel he's a key star to this program's success this season, and he should be a leader.
I'll tell you what, there are a lot of upperclassmen who can lead the way on this team, and yet you can't argue that Junior has the talent that warrants a leadership role, even though he's only a freshman.
Take it to the basket!
Now Charles. Outside, Watson. McCarthy. Back to Watson. Pass to Charles. Goes up on the wing. It's good off the back rim and in.
Heads up play by Watson that time. Whipping the pass to the open teammate. Smart play.
Here's Junior. And foul called as he misses and will shoot two free throws. It's on Blackman. He's gone 3 for 4 from the line. And he makes the first of the 1-1. And so he hits both. Charles with it. And the foul called on Junior. So that'll be his second foul of the game. We're in single bonus, so they'll have the 1-1 chance now at the line. He's made 2 of his 3 attempts tonight.
And you know, Junior, the son of the legendary Duke, you know, Duke was a standout from Newark in his own right. But unfortunately and sadly, he passed just before Junior started playing organized basketball.
And you have to wonder if that's what spurred Junior to take up the family sport. Junior has probably heard all about the greatness of Duke his whole life. Now it's time for him to write his own name in Newark lore. And the D just a step slow, reacting to the step back.
The drive by Junior. And plenty of contact on that shot, so 2 free throws coming up. And the foul goes against Villanova.
Have to display disciplined defense against Junior. You don't want to bail out guys with his kind of skill set.
He's perfect from the line this time. Now the Wildcats with it, down by 15. Davis outside. And stolen by Junior from deep three-point range. And that's not gonna go. The clock runs out and we are headed to... And about halfway through, what have you seen from Junior thus far?
Thus far, an excellent caretaker of the rock. He's finding his teammates and still yet to turn the ball over.
And, you know, the turnover number can often be overlooked. Protecting the possession, pivotal in a game that so often comes down to the slightest of margins.
Well, it's been a great time to be a Villanova fan recently. A couple of national titles in the last decade will do that for you. One of the best programs in the country at the moment.
And it's good for 2.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Looking to make plays for others. We've seen this from him all night.
Yeah, he's spoiling us, Greg. I mean, this just another fantastic dime dropped right there. That one certainly should make the highlight reel.
From 13. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot and will go to the line. Crawford picks one up. And those titles for Villanova, 2016 and 2018.
Tell you what, this is truly a golden era for Wildcat basketball. You know, it's been a byproduct, I think, of the school being consistent and staying near the top of the polls on a regular basis. And, you know, as a result, typically the Wildcats are one of the top seeds in the tournament, too.
And, yep, that's good.
On a nice little roll here to start this half, connecting on their first 3 attempts.
This Wildcat squad struggling, and the foul called on Junior. That's his 3rd foul so far.
I don't know if there's been a more dominant team than the Villanova Wildcats in the last several years. They have been absolutely dominant in their conference, but also real dangerous come tournament time, too.
And Villanova winning their conference 5 of the last 6 seasons, that is no easy task, especially with the conference they play in. The way they recruit and continue to perform, this dominance may go on for a while.
Now here's Thompson. Still getting warmed up offensively, no buckets yet in the game for him. Here's Junior. And that one goes long.
Yeah, but they're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
Out to the right wing. Here's Benjamin. Inside. Junior with the bucket.
Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Yeah, but they better rally soon because they've given up 3 straight buckets in the paint.
Here's Here's McCarthy. He's covered by Thompson. Here's the fast break. And Junior throws it down.
Starts the fast break in style. You better be careful when you're dribbling around Junior.
Pass to McCarthy. Now here's Watson. And here's Blackman. Here's Watson. That shot missing. You guys, for a long time now, Villanova has been a great place for guards and wings with some incredible talent coming out of those positions.
And if you're a perimeter player, Villanova is a fantastic place to grow your game. The school has done a great job of developing the talent of their perimeter players. It's been a major strength of the program the last few decades.
Now here's Justice. Pass to Blackman. Let's it go from 14, and he knocks the jumper down.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Benjamin, Blackman defending. Torres outside. Junior with it. The three. And it's Justice with the rebound. Here's McCarthy. Pass to Charles. Justice. And the layup falls.
And they've really gotten on track here in the second half. After that shaky start, the field goal percentage steadily climbing. They couldn't make anything in that first break.
Gonzaga calls timeout. Now, here's Torres. A contributor to any team's success is the chemistry on the floor between the players. Do you guys think the brevity of college careers makes it harder to build those bonds?
I don't think so. No, these players are studying together, practicing together, living together. You instantly form strong connections in those situations.
Hey, I agree wholeheartedly. I mean, a lot of these guys are making friendships that are going to last a lifetime with their teammates. Just one more way in which these college seasons are where players are really forged on and off the floor.
Now, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
Junior drives in. The layup missed. Fisher, left side. Outside, Watson. Back to Fisher. And finished off by Fisher.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Thompson outside. Crawford. No good with the triple. Here's McCarthy. Makes it off the glass.
And that's right where they wanted to go with the ball, in rhythm.
Now here's Junior. Covered by Fisher. Pass to Crawford. Torres. Now Thompson. Junior right side. Here's Benjamin. Covered by Fisher. Benjamin gets the bucket. One thing that makes these games extra special to me is that we could be seeing parts of the future NBA championship team out there.
You know, if only you could pick them out, right? Forecast the future a bit. I agree. That question in the back of your mind, is this a future MVP? Adds another layer of interest.
It's tough to think about how many of these players have that dream for themselves, knowing only the very best are going to take that next step and join the league.
Now here's Watson.
Not a whole lot going down for him at this point. He just can't buy a break.
Pass to Crawford. Good, and the assist goes to Junior.
And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, not taking any chances, Greg. This is how you close a game out. Textbook.
9-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And here's Fisher. It's good.
Boy, when you have a forward like Watson dropping dimes like that, it's a great sign for this team offensively.
Pass to Crawford. Back to Junior. Now here's Crawford. Not a lot of room. Junior. Here's Benjamin. So no problem for Gonzaga as they get the win.
And the strong performance from Junior, a big reason they won it going away. I mean, he never let up on the gas pedal. Pedal to the metal by Junior.
And that's the killer instinct that teams are looking for at the next level. With performances like this one, definitely improving his draft stock, if you ask me.
And that'll do it. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. So long.
Yes, this is a good thing. We got the W, you did your thing. Alex Williams is gonna be hyping you up for sure.
I'm just glad we got the win. It's one step closer to the tourney.
And Alex Williams, both can be true, Junior.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but I'm about the team. That's my mentality, always has been, always will be. Alex Williams or no Alex Williams.
Yeah, and I hear that, but look, at this level and the next level, the media is going to overanalyze every move we make on and off the court, and it's affecting the team because they're hearing it and they're reading it.
Mm-hmm.
If Alex Williams is burying you, then we all dealing with it. But look, your draft stock will rise. You'll see.
I ain't mad at that. As long as we keep winning, everything else will take care of itself.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that was funny. That was funny.
Hey, you want to find this? Save the ocean.
Sorry.
Yeah, I'm going to catch up with y'all later.
Okay, see ya.
Catch
you later.
What's up, Junior? Good to see you.
You too, Arch. Man, I got to walk.
So look, I'll get right to the point. I know what happened between Coach Bishop and I is still eating at you.
Yeah, it didn't sit right. Look, I want everything to work out between us, but Coach Bishop don't trust you, and he just wants what's best for me.
Hey, so do I.
Yeah. But you still want to get paid if I make it to the NBA, which is fair.
You know, I got you here.
You did?
When you had your choice of schools, I never tried to nudge you either way.
That's right.
I was surviving before we met, Junior, and I'd still be surviving if you decided to never play basketball.
Look, Art, you got me here. And I love this place and what I'm trying to accomplish for this school, but things can change if I don't feel like they're working out. I just want that to be clear.
Okay. We don't have a contract. That's clear. All I can do is keep trying to earn your trust.
Okay.
So, you ready to see what the inside word on your draft stock is?
Definitely.
All right, so look. I gathered all my intel into one place for you to take a look at, but it can update as the season goes.
Okay, so what's this all supposed to mean right now?
Nothing yet, but it'll all shape up as we get closer to the end of the season. Just keep winning, keep your numbers up, and your stock will rise.
Okay. If we're losing and I'm not producing, then it'll fall.
I mean, I was going to say it's not that simple, but it kind of is.
All right. Work to do.
So,
catch you later, Arch.
All right, boy.
Pardon me. Thank you.
Go
Can I help you?
You're Junior, right?
Yeah, that's right.
I'm Alex Williams. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. How'd you get on the bus?
How did I get on the bus?
Yeah.
You'd be surprised by how many people think press pass means all access. Can I say what a pleasure it is to meet Mr. Big Time Professor Dunk himself? I'm just wondering whether I should call you a selfish player, a chemistry risk, or, you know, tell the truth and let everyone know you did it for a girl.
Who told you that?
I never reveal my sources. But his name rhymes with Ted.
Listen, these other players that you're covering, mm-hmm. Yeah, they don't get the same, let's just call it attention.
Attention.
Yeah, attention.
Yeah.
So what's the deal with it?
What's the deal? Well, I get it. It may seem cruel or, you know, arbitrary, but it's the opposite. I love the potential of who you are and what your game is all about. At times, it can be inspiring.
Okay, and at other times?
At other times, not so much, but you're growing and developing, and this is my way of helping you reach your potential.
So why can't you just say that in an article? What's with all these games?
Because I'm building a profile too. And games, conflict, that gets eyeballs and clicks. And what if you don't develop? I write a cuddly piece about you, and then what? NBA decision makers pay attention to what I say. I've built a career on honest, unmerciful critiques, and I'm not backing down from that now. Look, the stakes are impossible at this level, Junior. You know that. And even worse when you get to the next level. You might as well prepare for it now. Everyone knew your dad was up for it. It's a long shadow that follows you around. Is that funny?
It is, because it's an angle. Trust me, I get where you're coming from. But the media is a lot more twisted about the legacy of Duke than I am.
Am I supposed to take that at face value?
I'm assuming you got another challenge for me.
Yeah, I do. Two games, first and foremost. I'm all about winners, so win the games. Secondly, everyone wants to see you develop as a scorer. So bump your scoring average up from where it is now. What do you say?
Challenge accepted.
Challenge accepted. Nice. Something about you. Professor Dunk. Mr. Big Time.
Red.